Hello everyone and welcome back to my YouTube channel. So in today's video, I'm going to be doing a tag video inspired by Annette from Annette's Makeup Corner. I'm pretty sure that she created this tag, but I'm not 100% sure, but I am going to leave her channel and her video down in the description below. She did a video, if I could only keep 10 palettes, what would they be? Basically, if all of your eyeshadow palettes got taken away, which 10 would you keep? So yeah, I've got 10 palettes sitting right beside me, and I'm just gonna name all of them off. I'm gonna tell you why I would keep them, why I love them, and I'm gonna be swatching them just cause like I wanna show you like how they work and how they look and things like that. Yeah, if you wanna see that, then just keep on watching. I hope you enjoy, and don't forget to check out Annette from Annette's Makeup Corner. Whole lot of people need to hear this. It's a lot of names on my hit list. Before we begin, I do want to say that I am going to be wearing my glasses for this because a lot of the times when I do tag videos and I'm just sitting here, I like go out of focus or my camera is like blurry. So I want to like be in focus like the whole time so I don't have to refilm this. So yeah, I am very, very blind and I never wear my glasses when I have makeup on just because of these lashes. I guess I should take them off to like show you the lashes that I'm wearing. The lashes that I'm wearing are the Coffee Talk lashes in the style Foxy. I will leave a link in the description to go shop them. I love them so much and I just like promoting lashes that I wear because I'm obsessed. Okay, so before I picked out all of my 10 palettes that I wanted to mention in today's video, I was just like kind of like going through and seeing what I would want in my collection within like the 10 palettes. And I am like a rainbow queen, king, like whatever you want to call me. I really love doing colorful looks, as you can see right here. So I do a lot of color, so I definitely wanted to make sure that I had like a full rainbow selection. And a lot of times I can't find one palette that I like that has all of the colors. So there are like scattered, like it isn't like one rainbow palette and the rest are neutral. But yeah, and these necessarily aren't my favorite palettes. I would just want them in my collection. The first palette is the Ace Beauté Oceanic palette. I love this palette so much. I will show you the inside. It is the perfect, and when I say perfect, I mean perfect, blue-green eyeshadow palette. I lusted over this palette forever and I finally gave in and just bought it because with the previous Ace Beauté palette that I own, which I'm not going to be mentioning today, I don't really like it that much just because the formula is a little like, it's like hit or miss like all the time. And a lot of people either hate Ace Beauté or they like really love their formula, or at least I love this palette. It is just so pigmented. I'm going to swatch two of the shades for you. So this right here is Mykonos, and this right here is Lagoon. Just see how pigmented they are. I'm not really good at swatching, and it's a little staining from a lipstick that I used earlier, but it's just so pigmented. I feel their formula is a little bit drier, but I mean, it performs amazing. It's very, very, like, blendable. I'm not wearing it on my eyes today, but I've used it, like, literally so many times. I feel like this is, like, one of my most used palettes of 2019. The second palette that I would keep would be the Queen palette from the Fumi and Juvia's Place collaboration. I love this palette so much, and it technically is considered an eyeshadow palette. But on the back right here, it says multifunctional palette, which means you can use it for the face or the eyes. And I love to use it for the face more than the eyes, so I definitely would have to keep it because I love to use it as blush and highlighter. I'm actually wearing this shade right here, FDV Approved, as highlighter right here, and it is just so stunning. And it's the perfect shade for my skin tone at this moment. Now, where it is a multifunctional, it isn't as pigmented as a regular eyeshadow because you can't, like, use eyeshadow strictly for blush, you know what I mean? I mean, you can, but you have to go very, very light-handed, so I feel they kind of, like, toned it down to make it multifunctional, which I don't really like, so I like to use it more for the face. But I am going to swatch the highlighter shade and then my favorite blush. The red shade right here that I love to use as blush, it is just so perfect. It blends so amazing. And then I have the like lighter shimmer in there that I love to use as highlighter, which is the FDV Approved shade. Look at that. It's like so blinding. It does have a little yellow undertone, so when I'm like really, really pale, I can't use it, but you know. And then this is the red shade, Owl. Now this is what it looks like just swatched, and it's not as pigmented. That's why I don't really like to use it for the eyes as well, but it's amazing on the face, so I would definitely have to keep it because it's amazing. The third palette that I would keep would be the Menagerie Killer Purr palette. So this is one of those incidents where this isn't necessarily one of my favorite palettes. It's a little bit more on the neutral side, so that is why I don't really like it that much. But the formula is amazing besides the two shimmers. I just had a lot of trouble with them when I played with it on my channel. But this is my only palette from Menagerie Cosmetics. It's the only one that I've really been interested in, just because I have a ton of shades that are like in their other palettes. But I definitely want to shop more for them because I just really love this palette. So I definitely had to put it in one of the 10 palettes because it's the only palette that I own for them, and I really love their formula. And just like, look at the color scheme compared to the cover. It just matches it perfect. Like, see, matches perfect. So I'm gonna swatch the teal and then the like gray green color. This is the teal and this is kind of like the like grayish grungy green. And when I tell you, they are so pigmented. They are so pigmented. Now they do kind of stain, which I haven't had blues to stain literally ever. So that's a little weird, but I really love the palette. And staining really doesn't like, it doesn't like make me not buy a palette, because like a palette's gonna stain. The fourth palette that I would put in here is the Alien palette from Jeffree Star Cosmetics. This is one of my favorite palettes for him. Besides the bulky packaging, I don't really like. And right here, it kind of like slips. I don't know if you can see that. Like, it slips very, very easy. And it like shows the black shade. But the formula is amazing and I really, really enjoy this palette. The color scheme is very, very right up my alley and I feel it's perfect for the holidays. Now this isn't like one of his like most recent palettes, but it is still one of my favorites and I definitely would have to put it in my collection if I could only keep 10 palettes. So I definitely wanted to like show this off because it's so cute. And I mean, yeah, the packaging's bulky, but it is cute. It's just bulky, so if you don't like bulky packaging, you won't like it. But I'm gonna swatch the shimmery green and the purple because those are my two favorite shades in this palette. This is what they look like right here. So pigmented. I'm gonna swatch them right here. Just like, look at that. Like, look at, well, it is like a little weird because of my finger, the way I swatched it, but it is so pretty. Like, and I love Jeffree Star's formula. Other than the shimmers, they do kind of sting if they get in your eye. So like I was saying, all of the palettes that I'm mentioning, they're not necessarily one of my favorites unless I say they are. But the palette that I'm about to mention isn't necessarily one of my favorites because it's just an orange palette. But the only reason that I put it in here is because I'm gonna need orange if I can only keep 10 palettes. And I really love ColourPop's formula. And this palette was like super cheap, except the packaging is kind of like, I mean, it's plastic and it's very, very delicate because I believe this shade is supposed to go here and this shade's supposed to go there, but like all the shades fell out and I'm not sure how you get them back out, and I don't want to like rip up the shade. So I'm gonna swatch the shimmery orange and then just the matte orange and just like show you the formula because it's so pigmented, so cute, and I love this palette and I would definitely need it in my collection if I could only keep 10 palettes. And ColourPop is super cheap and affordable, so I definitely wanted to mention them. Okay, so we're going to mention Jeffree Star again because I love this next palette. This is his collab with Morphe and Jeffree Star. This is the Morphe and Jeffree Star Artistry palette. Now, originally, I wasn't going to put this in here, but very last second, I was like, wait, I really love this palette and I love the color story. And I can just make so many looks with it. And I really actually like the loose glitter, which I'm actually going to swatch. So just get ready for that. But I like it and I feel like I get a lot of use out of it, and the formula is very nice and it's very affordable. So you get like the Jeffree Star formula for a lot cheaper, but this is what the palette looks like right here. I have a ton of tutorials with this palette. And for every palette that I'm mentioning, I will link videos that I've used them on my channel in the description below. So if you're like looking for a specific palette or a tutorial with the palette, then just like look in the description. I'll like label it and like which palette it is, what video, and you can just like go check it out. But because I know I have like a lot of videos with this, but this is what the color scheme looks like. It is a little bit of a bigger palette, which I don't really like bigger palettes, but I had to get this because it's Jeffree Star, so you know. So I'm gonna swatch a loose glitter Millions and then shimmery burgundy Don't Know Her. The loose glitter is so pretty, and this is actually my very first or only Morphe glitter. I do feel this one's like a little stickier than like normal, like the ColourPop ones aren't as sticky, but it's still pretty, so I wanted to put it in here. And this shade right here is To Die For. I love it so very much. I have glitter all over my hand, so yeah, that's great. The seventh palette that I would be keeping is my ColourPop custom palette. I just love the whole idea of customizing your own palette, and especially at ColourPop's price, you really can't beat it. When I got this, I got so much use out of it, and I still do. I used the blue and black today. And I just always am reaching for this. And so I felt I definitely had to put it in here. And I feel the reason that I like reach for it so much is because there's not one neutral except for the black and then this like pale shade, which I use like literally all the time. So I definitely had to put it in there. But I'm gonna swatch the lavender and then the shimmery pink, which I don't actually have a shimmery pink, so that's why I put it in there. I have a whole video on this, like unboxing it and showing and saying like why I got each shade. So there definitely will be information in that video about this palette. Like, just look at it. I know this glitter from that Morphe palette with Jeffree Star, but just like look at it. It's so pigmented. But if you're looking to customize a palette at ColourPop on their site, wait for them to have a sale because they have one like literally all the time. So if the setup is a little different, I did take a break because I don't know, after like talking a little bit in the video, my voice starts to hurt and like I get like a little like a mouth dry, but I always keep a bottle of water sitting beside me. So I don't really know like what's going on with that. But the 8th palette, I think it is 8 or 9, I don't know. The 8th. Maybe it's not the 8th, I don't know. But it's the Blood Sugar palette from Jeffree Star Cosmetics. I love this palette so much, except for like the little clamps and like the bulky packaging. Yet I honestly wish Jeffree Star would make his packaging not as bulky and lower the price on his palettes, because honestly, like $52 for each palette is a little expensive. But if you don't have a Jeffree Star palette, they definitely live up to the price. But this is the Blood Sugar palette right here. I will slide over so you can see it. I love it so much, and I'm actually wearing this shade right here all over my lid. But it's just so pigmented. It does stain very, very badly, so I know I'm gonna have like a pink stain right there. But you know what? You gotta do what you gotta do. I feel it's like a perfect red palette. Even though the reds aren't like true reds, they do lean more purple and like bluey. But they are very, very cute, and I love this palette so very much. Now that I think about it, I've mentioned a lot of Jeffree Star, so sorry, not sorry. The 9th palette that I'm gonna mention is the Morphe and Jaclyn Hill collaboration, the original palette. This is what she looks like right here. She's very, very large, but it has a ton of neutrals in it, and I definitely know that in my 10 palettes, I'm gonna need a lot of neutrals. And a lot of palettes that I've mentioned already don't have a lot of neutrals. So I definitely know that I could reach to this palette because I love the formula. 10th and final palette that I'm gonna be talking about is the ColourPop Frozen 2 Elsa palette. This is what she looks like. I just love ColourPop's 9 pen palettes. I feel so inspired every time I see them. But I just love this palette for the holidays especially, and I've used it a lot, like literally already. I have a dent in the glitter. I don't know if it'll show it right there. Just because I love it so very much, and it's just so stunning. And so I wanted to show y'all because I've did a ton of videos on my channel with this palette, so definitely go check them out. But I just love this. The only thing I don't like about this palette is the font of the letters, of the words and like shades. They're so hard to read. But it's a stunning palette. I love the packaging. I love that it's cardboard. And I wouldn't swatch every palette. I just don't feel like wiping my hand off. And I have like a lot of glitter, so the shades that I'm swatching aren't working over top of that, so I probably shouldn't swatch the glitter. But just know if you ever use the glitter in the Morphe and Jeffree Star palette, that it's gonna be there for like ever, so get ready for that. Thank you so much for watching. If you are watching this video, I tag you to do it. I know this isn't like my video, but if you're watching, do this. Let me know your 10 palettes that you would keep in the comments below. Even if you don't have a YouTube channel, or if you do have a YouTube channel and you do this, then let me know and I'll go watch it. Thank you all so much for watching, and I hope you enjoyed today's video. Make sure you give it a big thumbs up and don't forget to subscribe to my channel. I post new videos every Tuesday and Friday, but I did just get over a little bit of a bug, so I wasn't able to pre-film to get Tuesday's video out. So I know that we're kind of like behind, and I know it's not Tuesday, but you gotta do what you gotta do. Thank you so much for watching, and I will see you in my next video. Bye guys. Okay, guess we're doing just fine.